Fox. I can't wait. Time now
for Let's Go. First.
The K-Man, you're up first. You love Chris Beard getting fired up.
Oh, he got thrown out. And this is the classic part. He sits on the ground, and he's claiming that a West Virginia player called a timeout, which he didn't. So that's why he gets thrown out. But here's the thing. And I said this earlier when college basketball made this rule, and then the NBA followed suit. The refs are like, you know what? I'm not going to get berated by a guy wearing a polo shirt. I'm just not. There is a ceiling to how mad you can get in a bathing suit. It's about right here. There's a ceiling to how mad you can get in a polo shirt. It's about right there. You want to scream at me in a suit? The bank manager comes out and yells at me for doing something? All right, bank manager, you got me. You want to wear a tuxedo and yell at me like Frank Sinatra? Okay, I'm sorry, sir. But if you're going to try to dress me down in a polo shirt, out of the game. See you later, Chris Beard. So you want to wear a suit? I will get you in the game.
Oh, polo shirt,
gone.
That's great. Hey, guys, I went back to watch highlights of the Super Bowl because I wanted to see how much of the game, the loss, could you actually pin on Mahomes. And what I saw from watching this actual game footage is that it's not much, is that Mahomes really only had like 0.00001 seconds to get the ball out. Other things I noticed, not as many fans as I thought when I watched. I didn't like how professional the uniforms were that they were wearing. But a lot of this you can't really put on Mahomes. So, Nick, I got to give you credit. Balls being dropped left and right.
Thank
and
you,
watching
Jim.
This real actual game yep. footage, not on Mahomes. I would not put
not
this
his
loss
fault.
On Patrick Mahomes, buddy. Not his fault. Not his fault.
Appreciate that, Jenna. All right, one in-house note quickly for my butt first. Some folks have asked and wondered why I'm in for Colin this week. Colin, you can go to his Instagram. He explained it firsthand yesterday. My dear friend, someone that I love with all my heart, and I know all of us care for Colin, but I have a special relationship with him. He has helped me in ways the audience will never know, was hospitalized this weekend. Now, he's going to be okay. He's already out of the hospital. But Sunday was terrifying for, I think, all involved. And so that's why Colin is not hosting his show on a week where he desperately wants to host his show. So he's going to be all right. He's back home. He's with his family. But on my behalf and on behalf of everyone at FS1 and certainly everyone on this show, our best wishes and thoughts with Colin as he gets back healthy and hopefully gets back on TV very, very soon. But in the meantime, Colin, I'll hold you down on the herd. I got your back, brother.
Absolutely everything awesome. That Nick said there. And Colin left a nice message to his fans and everyone on Instagram, Twitter. Definitely check that out. All right, we'll take a turn. Talk some Philadelphia.